Yo, what is going on, guys? My name is Yankee, and welcome back to a brand new video. Today, we're gonna go ahead and showcase to you some of the absolute best tips on how you guys can win every single gunfight here in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. So, there's a lot of issues that some people have been running into recently with the extended health in the game, and just with some of the weapons maybe not performing the way that they would hope to. So, in today's video, we're gonna go ahead and give you guys some of the absolute best tips to go ahead and win every single gunfight, get some bigger kill streaks in this game, and hopefully it'll help you guys improve at the same time. But before we get into that, I do want to go ahead and ask each and every single one of you guys, smack an early like on today's video. If we can get to 100 likes, it'd be really greatly appreciated. It helps the channel a ton. Also, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. We are literally less than 10 subscribers away from 16,000 at the time of recording this video. So if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Turn on post notifications to never miss an future upload. Also, let's give a shout out to people with the notifications on here in the channel. If you guys want to be featured in a future upload, comment hashtag and notification squad down in the comment section below to possibly be featured in a future video. Now, without further ado, let's get into this. We have 7 tips that's gonna make you guys some of the absolute best players here in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. I think you guys are really gonna go ahead and enjoy some of them. So without further ado, let's get into it with the very first tip. It is gonna be telling you guys to slow your game down. Now, this might sound kind of stupid. You guys be like, why am I gonna slow my game down? I'm playing aggressive or I'm playing the objective. Why in the world would I wanna slow my game down just so I can go ahead and win more gunfights? And guys, with the extended health in this game, it is very, very difficult to get used to at first. Personally, for me, I'm still trying to get used to the health in this game. It's something that even though it's only an extra 50 damage that people are that you're gonna be doing to the enemies to actually kill them, it's something for me that it was just really hard. Even when I went to hardcore at first, then I came back to core, it was something that I just was not really able to get used to at first, and it took me a very, very long time. So when you actually slow your game down, you're not gonna be able to just rush everywhere. You're gonna be able to win more gunfights, because when you're playing super, super aggressive and you're just running out in the middle of the map or you're running into the enemy spawn, more than likely not, you're gonna end up running into a group of like 2 or 3 enemies at a time, and you're not gonna be able to take them all out. You might be able to take like 1 or 2 of them out, but that third person always is gonna kill you. That's something I'm still struggling with, just trying to slow my game down a little bit, because I'm someone that back in World War II and back in Infinite Warfare, I went balls deep. I would rush everything I possibly could, try to get into that enemy base, and really I dominated that way. But the way I'm playing in this game, it's just unfortunately it's not this. I'm not able to do the same thing because of the health in this game. So slowing my game to play down a little bit, sticking to the outskirts of the map and maybe not pushing every single thing definitely has helped me out so far. Hopefully it's gonna help you guys out too. You gotta remember, this is no longer a jetpack Call of Duty game, so there's no like jumping up in the air to get away from gunfights. If you're in a gunfight and you can't get out of it, there's almost absolutely no way to get away from it unless you're gonna be able to like possibly sit on like a head glitch or something like that. But more than likely not, you're gonna be trying to get into that enemy base. So slowing your game down and just really playing a little more consistent, like playing a little more strategic instead of just really aggressive, is really going to help you out. So anyway, moving on to number 2, this is gonna be a huge one, guys. This is absolutely like a dire tip that you guys definitely are going to need to use. It's going to be use an assault rifle. So back in the Black Ops 4 beta, the number one weapon everybody used was submachine guns. Those guns were so freaking good. I absolutely loved using them, but all of a sudden they just completely nerfed them to the point where the submachine guns are just not a valuable option whatsoever now. So the assault rifles are so much better than every other gun in the game. You can even talk about some of the 3-round burst guns, kind of like the Swordfish and the ABR. Those are pretty good too, so you can put that in the list, but I really would say the assault rifles are 10 times better. For example, like the ICR, like the Vapor, those are like the top 2 weapons in the game, especially the Maddox is up there as well. Really, really good weapons. Definitely make sure you're using an assault rifle and not those SMGs, because I remember I used the MX9 so much in that beta, and I had so much fun just melting people. It's just not the same. It's taking me like almost 6 to 7 bullets with an SMG to get a kill, compared to like 3 or 4 bullets with an assault rifle. Even with the extended health, it helps so much more, but assault rifles are just that dominant weapon at the moment that everybody seems to be using. If you turn a corner, there's most likely somebody that's going to be taking you guys out with an assault rifle. Even at close range gunfights, the assault rifles at the moment are better than submachine guns. Maybe in the future they're going to go ahead and they're going to buff these SMGs, but at the moment, and maybe we'll make a follow-up video in the future, but for now, the assault rifles are just that good. You cannot really use anything else besides just those. But moving on to tip number 3, it is going to be to pre-aim everything. And the reason why I'm saying this, head glitches are everywhere, and every single time you turn a corner, it's almost like an 85 to 90% chance there's gonna be, you're gonna see somebody head glitching a spot and waiting for you as soon as you turn that corner. Especially since this game is now just completely objective based, everybody's just hopping on those objectives and having eyes on them almost at all times. So especially if you're playing control, for example, and you're hopping on that point to try and get some points and just trying to capture the place, I guarantee you there's most likely gonna be somebody sitting like in a farther distance with an assault rifle on a head glitch, and you're just not gonna be able to do anything to him unless you're pre-aiming him. You know that he's gonna be there. You just gotta pretty much every single time you turn a corner, just assume that somebody's gonna be there every single time and you're ready to shoot right away as soon as you make that turn to the corner. Maybe just like try to move around a little bit when you're ADSing, just like moving right and left, just so you can hopefully get away from their bullets and hopefully you'll be have the objective, you'll have the advantage to taking them out because you already are gonna expecting somebody to be there. Huge, huge tip, guys. That's something I've been using so much often. Literally, if you guys are not pre-aiming every single corner, even if there's not gonna be somebody there, even if you have a UAV and there's not really a red dot there, do it just in case because it's gonna help you. It's gonna stick to your head. It's gonna help you. Just remember, every single time you turn a corner, make sure you pre-aim. It's gonna be, before you know it, muscle memory, and it's gonna happen every single time. It's gonna make you that much better of a player. But we're gonna be moving on now to a few attachments that I feel is just absolutely necessities here in the game. Like, literally, there's some attachments that you don't even need to use compared to these attachments right here. Number one, the one that I really like is a long barrel. Now, before you guys are wondering, like, why am I gonna say long barrel here? Like, listen to me real quick. Before I put long barrel on here, if you guys were watching some of my streams, I was getting melted every single time, no matter where it was. If I was melting somebody off of a head glitch, I was taking me 5 to 6 bullets and they were still not dying. And then as soon as I threw long barrel on, it just helped me that much better. And I was able to win plenty of more gunfights. Long barrel actually extends your range by 2 on different assault rifles, especially like the ICR, the one that I've been using the most, and makes your the range extended by 2 on your stats for assault rifles, which is huge. It's gonna make you that much better of a player. It's gonna make you win more gunfights, and you're gonna be able to literally just pretty much go on crazy kill streaks with this. But moving on to the next attachment here, it's gonna be grip and grip 2. Now, I really have only been using grip, but I just recently started using grip 2 as well, and literally it's a laser beam. You are literally not going to lose any gunfights with both of those attachments. I know it's 3 attachments I'm asking you guys to run, but it's going to be so beneficial to you that you're literally going to thank me later. So grip, basically all it does is just reduce your recoil when you're aiming down sights, pretty much exactly how it is in every other Call of Duty game. But when you throw grip 2 on here, this is where things get super crazy. When I'm watching kill cams, I'm like, how are these guys melting me this fast? It's literally because they're using this grip 2 as well. I would not even think to have to use literally 2 different attachment slots for grip, but it is so beneficial to you. It's gonna minimize your recoil while you're aiming down before you're firing, and it's also going to reduce the flinch when you're aiming down your sights at the same time. Literally, the flinch in this game is so unpredictable. It's so annoying sometimes that if you literally miss one shot, even though just because of flinch, you're literally gonna lose the entire gunfight, because that is how difficult it is with this different health in the game. That literally, it's 150 health. It would seem like if you just miss a shot, it's okay. You can just completely annihilate them with the next ones. But it just, for some reason, when there's 150 health, if you miss a shot, you're completely done at that point. I don't understand it, but it literally is gonna help you so much. Grip 2, grip 1, long barrel, a must have attachments. I know that's 3 attachments you're gonna need to run, but I promise you, you will thank me later. You're gonna win every single gunfight with these attachments. It's gonna happen, guys, I promise you. But we're gonna move on to a few different other little things that you should throw onto your class setup as well, and that's gonna be a stim shot. It kind of sounds self-explanatory already. Stim shot is huge in this game, but the reason why I like stim shot instead of using armored in this game is because you get your health back so quickly when you're using it. Literally, somebody could just put you down, you know, like you're one shot right away. You just hide behind a rock or you hide behind a head glitch real quick. You press L1, you get your health back in literally less than a second. You're back in the gunfight while these guys are pushing you. They're not gonna expect it. You're gonna get the kill much, much faster that way. Technically, when you have stim shot, the way that I like to look at it, maybe you guys think I'm crazy for thinking this, but when I have stim shot on, it almost makes me think I have 300 health the entire time when I'm playing. And the reason why, there's a few different times where like I'm just getting shot from behind real quick. I hit L1 while I'm turning around at the same time, so I'm still healing my health. I'm still healing while I'm getting shot at, so it's literally taking more damage for me to actually die. I turn around, I melt this guy, and he has no idea how I killed him because he's literally just still spraying me down. I'm still taking so much damage. It's almost better than having armored on anyway, because if you are able to time it correctly and hit L1 while you're still getting shot at, it almost is like you have 300 health at the same time compared to your 150. So it's double the health almost at some points when you do have stim shot on. You might think I'm crazy about that, but it has helped me at multiple different times having that. I think stim shot is 10 times better than armored, because in armored you don't really get to heal up that quickly. Literally, even if you like lose your armor real quick, you need to press L1 to heal. It's still gonna take way too long to get your health back, and it's just by that time you get it fully back, you're already dead at that point. So I definitely like stim shot way better than armor in that situation. But finally, last but not least, the final tip I can give you guys, recon as your specialist here over some of the other ones here. Some of the other specialists are very, very good, but I really like recon just for the main fact that they have the ability to have vision pulse here, and that is your specialist ability. You only get it like 2 to 3 times in a match, but it actually really will help you, especially if you're on a streak and you're just trying to like figure out exactly where they are. If you're in the enemy base, you can literally start pre-firing them before they even turn a corner, and that's gonna help you even get the better advantage as well to win more gunfights at the same time. So those are 7 tips that I can help you guys with to win more gunfights here in Call of Duty. Black Ops 4, and you should be able to win almost every single gunfight as long as you get that first shot off. Let me know what you guys think of the list. If there's anything else that I missed, definitely let me know down in the comment section below. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you guys have not already, smack that like button. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. We are on that road to 16,000 subscribers, and I'll catch you all in the next video. Have a great rest of your day, and peace out.